Hi, and welcome to this video by TechyV.com, your solution provider. I'm Frank, and I'll show you how to download, install, and configure Mozilla Thunderbird with your Gmail account. Okay, Thunderbird is a cross-platform, free, and open-source email and news client created by the non-profit organization Mozilla Foundation. Now you may wonder, what's an email client? Okay, think about it. To check your emails, you always need to open your internet browser, log into your account, and then browse your emails live on the internet. And without your internet and your browser, you are unable to access it. But how about you download all your emails in your hard disk and read them, draft your emails anytime, even you're out of internet, that is your offline. And this facility you can get using an email client. But there are many email clients you can get, like Microsoft Outlook, Apple's Mail, Uter, and so many. But Mozilla Thunderbird, the first reason most users prefer it because it's extensible. So you can add more features created by Mozilla Foundation or any other third-party developers. And secondly, it's cross-platform based, so it supports Windows, Linux, macOS, and such other. So let me show you how to download Thunderbird. Open a web browser and go to www.google.com and in the search box type Mozilla Thunderbird and press enter to search. Then click on the first link, that is getthunderbird.com, Mozilla Thunderbird, to go to the download page. Okay, this is the link. By clicking on this link, the download pop-up window will appear and you can save your setup file from there. But I'm not going to do this because I already have the setup file. I'm going to launch it directly from there. So here it is. Just double click on it to run it. Okay, so extraction is done. This is your introduction to Thunderbird. Click next to proceed. By clicking next here, you'll install according to the default settings. If to change it, click here to select custom. If this box is checked, then Thunderbird will be your default email client. Click next. This will be your destination folder. If you want to change it, click browse and browse your directory from here. Click next. This the shortcuts will be created. If you want to change it, then click to deselect any of this. Then click next and then click install to start your installation process. Okay, it's done now. Okay, if this box is checked and click finish now, then Thunderbird will be launched automatically, but I'm not going to launch it now. First I'm going to configure my email, so I'm just deselecting it and clicking finish. Okay, now it's time to configure your Thunderbird with your email account, and I'm showing you this by my Gmail account. This can be done by two ways. One is IMAP, that is Internet Message Access Protocol. This allows you to access your emails live via server, and emails can be downloaded selectively. Another way is POP, that is Post Office Protocol. This downloads all your emails first. So let's get started. Now log into your Gmail account. Now in the top left corner you can see a wheel icon. Click on it and click mail settings. Now click forwarding POP and IMAP. You can see POP is already enabled by default. All you have to do is just enable IMAP settings, and if POP is disabled here, just click here to enable your POP service as well. Then click save changes to done it. Okay, it's done. Now I'll show you to configure it with Thunderbird. Okay, it's time to configure your Mozilla Thunderbird. So double click on it to run your Thunderbird. In this screen you type your name, your email you wanna synchronize with, then click continue. This will check up your information you provided. Okay, you'll be selected to the IMAP settings, and if you want to keep IMAP settings, then just click create account. But if you want to select POP3 settings, then you have to select POP3 and click manual config. Then this will incoming will be your POP3. All you have to do is just change this address to pop.gmail.com, and the others will be as it is. Then click reset. Okay, it's done. Now click create account to complete it. Okay, welcome to your Thunderbird interface. If you change your mind and want to switch to IMAP, then you can do this again or create new accounts by clicking on the tools tab, then click account settings. You can just remove this account and add it again with the IMAP settings. So that's it. Thanks for watching this video, and check out for more videos by TechyV.com.